Hello everyone. I suck at intros, so this is what you get. Okay, so we're gonna be making some Roblox VFX from the thumbnail, you can obviously see that this is some like laser beams and fireballs. We're gonna be making a tornado in Blender. So in order to do this, you need to have the following things: a basic knowledge of Blender 2.8, a version of Blender 2.8, and that should be it. So, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to press Shift A, and it's going to bring up this menu. So, because we're making a tornado, we just want to place a circle, so just click a circle. Now, with that, you're going to press your S key, and you're going to scale it down. Now, you're going to press Tab while your circle is selected, so you go into Edit Mode. Now, in Edit Mode, you're going to see you have these dots. These dots are vertices. So, with these vertices, you're going to use a Drag Select, and select them all. You're gonna press E to extrude and press Z to lock it to the Z axis. So you're gonna extrude it a little and expand it out. You're gonna repeat this process a few times, kind of like I am, until you get a nice tornado shape. So make sure it has a nice shape to it. The more out it is, usually the better it is. So the controls for this are you're going to E to extrude and S to do. So mine kind of looks like a teacup, so let's fix that. So by pressing Z brings up this menu, you go to wireframe mode, and you can select through all these things. So I can just select the vertices hassle free, and I can just boop. So now I'm editing my tornado, so now it doesn't look like a teacup. And instead it looks like a nice tornado. Now, the shape isn't really going to matter, and you'll see why in a minute. But now that you have this shape, you should be good to go. So what you're going to do first is you're going to go into edit mode. You're going to press A to select all. And keep in mind, to go into edit mode, you need to have your object selected. Press tab, and then you're going to be in edit mode. So then, while you're in edit mode, you press A, and it selects all of your vertices. Then what you're going to do is you're going to right-click with your mouse, so the right side of your mouse, and the first option, subdivide. So you're going to do that like 4 times. So now that you have like 1,000 vertices, you're just going to go all the way over here into this menu. So there should be a side menu. So these are like the location properties. These are modifiers. I don't know what these do. I don't know what those do. Those are for physics, so we're not going to use those. These are constraints. We're not going to use those. But vertex groups. So all what we're going to do is we're going to press plus, and we're going to press assign. Now we can safely exit edit mode. Now we're going to click on this wrench icon in object mode. So when you're in object mode, you shouldn't see all of this. This is what object mode looks like. This is what edit mode looks like. So in object mode, you're going to go to your wrench icon with all the modifiers. Then with your modifier, you're going to go with vertex weight edit. So because you just created that group here, where it says vertex group, you click it and you just click group. Now under here it's going to say fall off type. Fall off type is custom curve, and it's going to bring up this menu. So click on the right corner here and drag it up, and on the right corner drag it down. So it should be like this. Then what you need to do is texture mask. Press plus and texture coordinates, go to global, and then you're going to see these kind of like, I don't know what they are, but it'll bring you there, but this icon here, and it's going to say type a new image or movie, and then it's going to say none, blend clouds, click clouds, then go back to your wrench icon, and you can just press the arrow here. The second thing you're going to do is you're going to add a mask, and just keep the mask open. Then you're going to add a smooth. So with your smooth, you have your smooth right here. So these all the order matters a lot, so you should have your vertex weight edit, which is the first modifier, your mask, the second one, and the smooth, which should be the third one. The order matters a lot. So vertex group, you're gonna press group. And with smooth, you're gonna click here so you can edit, and you're gonna type 100. So now you see everything looks smooth. So under our mask, we're gonna go to vertex group, and we're gonna select our group. There's hold, our mesh starts deforming. So this is good. So with this, we're going to add another modifier. So we're going to go modifier and simple deform. So a simple deform in the angle, so make sure you can type in it, type 360. With 360, it's going to look weird. So under axis, you want to go Z. So with the Z axis, now it kind of looks more like a tornado. So what we're going to do is we're going to edit this stairs hold a bit. So if you want a more dense tornado that looks very thick, probably something like this, so around 0.381. But if you want like a lighter tornado like this, this works. So about 0.400. So I'm going to kind of go in the middle, so I like it right here. So now we have the basic shape, so we're going to start coloring it. So you're from your modifiers tab, just close, or don't touch any of these, just keep these how they are. And don't move your object, because it's going to mess with your orientation, so just keep it still. So render properties, so modifier properties, and you're going to press this TV icon. With this TV icon, you're going to go to bloom, so just click bloom. Now, go back to your modifiers, then you're going to see this kind of like earth kind icon thing. It's right under your vertex group, so it's your materials property. Once you're here, you're just going to press new. And what you're going to make sure you're going to do is you're press Z, so you have this menu, and you're going to drag down and release, and you should be in material view. And on your surface, you're going to press emission. For your strength, you're going to type in it and put 5. Now my tornado is going to be a fire tornado, so I'm going to make an orange. And for more detail, so if you already have the shape you want, or if you want to experiment with more, mainly you probably want to mess with the Thayer's hold and the angling. The smooth you shouldn't mess with, and this you shouldn't mess with. So the mask and the simple deform is what you should mess with. So after you have that, you need to apply these modifiers. So you have to do them in order. So just go top to bottom, like this. If you do it out of order, it will mess up how it looks, and it won't look good. So now your mesh should look like this in edit mode, but keep it in object mode. So what you're going to do is you select your mesh, right-click, press copy objects, right-click again, and press paste objects. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to lighten your color a bit so you have some variety. And now if I zoom in closely, you can see we kind of have a shade for a tornado. And also what you can do is you can rotate it a bit so it looks better. So you can keep on rotating it. I'm not going to really mess with it too much. So what you can do is you can put a ring around it, basically. So there's two ways you can do this. Now, this is a less popular method, but you can take a donut and do the similar process with the tornado. But we're not going to do that because it's not as effective. So we're going to go here. So Shift A, Mesh, and under Mesh, UV Sphere. So press UV Sphere. So you want to move your UV Sphere to the center of the tornado, so it's inside the tornado. Press S and just drag it out so it covers the entire tornado. Then with your sphere selected, press Tab. And press A to select all the vertices, right-click, subdivide 4 times, or 3 times. Subdivide like as many times as you want, just don't go over 4, basically. And subdivisions do change how it looks. So we need to set our vertex group, so it's a similar process. So I'm going to go a little more faster on this one. So object data properties, new vertex group, edit mode, select all of your vertices, press assign. Go to your modifiers tab. Go to vertex weight edit, select your vertex group, and you're going to do the same thing. So you're going to change your fall off type, go to custom curve, change it for the left all the way up, and the right all the way down. It should look like a diagonal angle. Now under texture mask, you're going to press new. Texture coordinates are going to be global, and the two lines are going to be clouds. And go back to your modifiers, close this, don't need to edit anymore. Go to mask. Under vertex group, you're going to press group. You're going to go to smooth under here. So it depends, because usually it might shrink it. So with the sphere, this isn't the case. So then just edit your Thayer's hold. So it might lag a bit because this is a sphere, so it has different object data. So what you're gonna do now is now you kind of have this like thing, so you don't want like a lot because what you're doing here is you kind of want to bring this down in a way. So like yeah, bring it down like that. So I'm gonna undo what I just did so you guys understand. So I have my object selected, I'm gonna press S and I'm gonna press Z. So that means I'm scaling it in on the X ac or the Z axis, sorry. So make sure you don't do it too much because it might disappear like it just did for me. Okay, so this is how I want mine. So simple deform. So we're gonna add our simple deform modifier. So it's here, it's under deform, simple deform, right here. So twist, just make it a 360 angle like it was before. Place it on the Z axis. Okay, so once that's done, you can play with the angling and stuff. I'm not really gonna play with it. So I'm gonna go straight to coloring. So I'm gonna select my mesh, or select this thing right here, not the tornado, but the thing around it. You're gonna press new, and where it says surface, you're gonna click that and find where it says emission. So press emission, change your strength to 5, and keep it white. So you can kind of like, you can make it a circle around it. I don't really feel like doing that. So I'm just gonna rotate it a little. So. Move it a little. So I'm. So see, so now you kind of have some VFX going on here. Now this is a very basic VFX. More advanced VFX comes from hand drawing your things, such as. But this is probably a good start using modifiers as it doesn't really involve much skill and it gets you with the basic form of everything. So that's going to be at the end of this video. So in the pinned comment, I'm going to put my Discord tag if you guys have any questions or need help with the video. And I'm going to put some other information. And also, I'm going to send you, or that's probably going to be it. I'll probably put my public Discord server in the link in the description. So make sure to join that. Make sure to like and subscribe. Peace out.